means we should expect Nakama to come out from Misfits here if it is going to be the exact same thing again. If they want to swap things up, maybe they want to take the Civet away from Xpeke. He was able to do a fair amount of damage, but at the same time did get caught out in a couple of fights.
So, looking like they want the Vlad real quick, like it's going to be blind picked up yet again by Selfie. He was able to make it work quite well last game. And thinking about the Karma, they're on the track to picking up the exact same composition.
I also think they'll stray away from the Gnar because they know the Aurelia will come out as a matchup against it. So likely they're just going to lock support here unless they really want to try the same thing again and think that they can execute just as well in the early game. That's exactly what they're going to do. Okay, well that puts us in an Aurelia Sivir position if we are going for exactly the same draft again. Does happen from time to time.
It's the same order as well.
If they take the Cassio, it isn't. Maybe change up the top lane matchup here if they want to. Not that Irelia was a bad matchup, but Soaz couldn't actually ever get ahead of the Gnar. Should have been a winning matchup.
I mean, there was some focus from Llama Bear. He overextended a little bit from time to time, and that was the issue. But in teamfights, he started to shine in the later stages of the game. But you know, you can never predict if a game is going to go 55 minutes long.
That's true. With Origen,
unless it's Origen, it's a bit more likely.
Yeah.
All right, same picks as Dan's. We got the Cassio, we got the Sivir.
Ah, but importantly, it's a different rotation here.
All right.
The Cassio was the last one. Now, that does change things, Pyra, because it allows Origen to kind of pivot away from the Aurelia if they want to as a last pick. If they want to opt for something different into the Gnar, I still think it's likely to be the Aurelia, but generally wouldn't really be saving this top for last pick if they were that set on it. So,
yeah.
The Aurelia, that is.
Misfits still have a lot of time to think about what they want to pick up.
It's
the
Lucian's
been consistent. The Karma is, of course,
still
available.
No, it's not.
The exact same. Oh, he locks the Jhin.
Ooh, Jhin.
All right, mixing it up on us.
Seen one game of Jhin out of Hans Sammer. A little bit less
potent.
A little less mobile. A lot less mobile.
Yeah.
And a lot more engaged comes out from Ignar.
Yeah, the Alistar.
Picks up his Alistar.
Here's the question. We definitely got are we going to get to see the protobelt Alistar? Because I've heard the fables. I want to see if they're true.
So, I'll explain that. In the Challenger Finals, Misfits were in game, I think it was game three. Game two and three both featured a protobelt on support. GP.
Something we thought we were going to see.
TLDR, Ignar got super far ahead and built protobelt. But the GP actually changes the dynamic fairly by quite a lot now, because obviously you have that global presence. Now you've got another late game threat. That is a difficulty, though, for Origen. When now you've got GP playing for the late game, you've got Cassio playing for the late game, and you've got a Sivir, who doesn't play for the late game but excels there. Like, I don't know how I feel about this, considering how quickly Misfits started off. But if Origen can drag this game out and extend it again, maybe we'll see a decent setup.
Yeah, I mean, Misfits have mixed it up just a little bit. They had the option to go for the same composition again, but this time they've opted into something that we haven't seen quite so much from them. I'm curious to see if that duo lane pays out. We could still see the lane swap, of course. How do you favor this 2v2?
I mean, it's kind of difficult to play the... It's not too bad. Honestly, it's not the one that we see too much in Europe anymore, but the Sivir Trundle is kind of safe unless you get in range of the Q flash, but Jhin always has damage, so
yeah.
I think I kind of have to give it to Misfits if ever they get into a 2v2, but still, I'm expecting more of a lane swap coming out.
Well, I asked you because I also want to ask everybody at home, who do you think's got the better one? Who do you think is going to take this away? The series is tied at 1-1. If you think Misfits will go one more game up, hashtag MSF win is what we want to see you tweeting at LOL Esports is the place. Or if you're still the Origen faithful, are they going to triumph in this one? They nearly did it two games in a row. It got turned back around at the end. Hashtag OG win. Defending their spot here in the European LCS, looking for spring of 2017. Well, we're about to find out who goes forward in this game, in this series. Misfits, Origen, let's get on the rift.
You asked me about the 2v2, and I immediately thought Hans Sammer was playing Lucian again. So I
that
was like,
changes
wait, hang
things
on,
a bit.
That changes things a lot.
Yeah. To be fair, you could be forgiven. He's played quite a lot of those. I didn't even
mean that, by
the way.
He's not in the promotion tournament.
Yes.
Like, don't worry.
Hans Sammer can be, God, what's another word I can use? It's hard, man. All right. Hybrid's still having a good time. Happy birthday to him.
I don't know. What is another word for forget?
That's a good question. I actually don't think I've ever
used it. Well, we'll put that one on the back burner for now. Game starting out. We're looking like we're in for standard lanes this time. Yeah, okay, there
like
we go.
Royal pardon?
Yeah.
I don't know whether that quite
counts. Those don't work where I'm from.
they especially work where I'm from. They don't get given out too often, but we'll see whether he does get royally pardoned.
For the gin pickup? That was one way to end it. All right. So this might be a bit different because last time Origen tried for the tried for the swap. Second time, they got the swap. This time, we got actual, legit standard lanes. So we get to see that 2v2 Ignar and Hansama and not facing down a Karma that can push him back, that can regen. But in the middle, the more some things change, the more they stay the same.
Now, one thing is a little different from what we have seen from a couple of Alistis in Europe. Not opting for Thunder Cow, so not going for the trade potential, but instead opting for the tankiness. That means Ignar is planning on going pretty ham there. Even though he's beef, he's going to go diving pretty spectacularly the longer this game goes on.
Yeah.
So,
got punished by Thunderlords on the Thresh, too.
Yeah.
Makes a lot of sense. Hansama already pushing up. Level 2 should be fairly even, of course.
Just trying to dodge away from a lot of what Hybrid is offering. Yeah. Fires off that fourth shot.
Moving pretty quick for not being on Lucian, though.
Hobbling quite effect.
Yeah. Swain-like movement.
Hans knows they need to at least put a couple of autos into this wave with Ignar, otherwise they're going to lose the level 2. But now you can see, look, Origen, while they don't have the push.
Oh, well, there we go.
Have to back away.
They can actually deny some farm here, just freezing it out. Continuing to harass Hybrid.
Oh,
can't stop that. There's the engage. Instantly exhausted Hansama. But they still got a lot of damage here. Ignar is tanking quite a bit.
Exhaust and heal used. And if Origen make that mistake again, there's a Q flash coming out from Ignar and a headbutt backwards. Amazing's going to look to try and salvage this lane, but you can see already Misfits are making trouble for them. But so is Llama Bear. Llama Bear is here.
Okay, good timing. Llama Bear with the backup, and now Hybrid and Peke realize they cannot contest this right now. Amazing has to back away. 2v2 is starting to get real spicy down there. Let's take a look up at the top side to Soaz. Started off looking good against Alfari. He's been pushed under tower for the moment.
Ah, the frustrations of playing GP into Gnar.
Oh, I know all about that.
When Gnar just autos the barrel.
Yeah.
And suddenly you can't get the combo off properly.
And that's when he just parlayed. Right into their face.
Try and give as much as you can before you take the damage in response. Alfari dancing on the edge of the turret. Aggro there. Power of Evil just got blue buff, trying to help through that early game as well. So trying to turn what has been a very, you know, back and forth matchup. We've seen Selfie more often than not take the lead in this matchup. But third time's the charm.
Yeah. Well, he rarely faces down somebody like Power of Evil either. So even though this is a fairly well-known matchup for him, it's third time he's been facing down. He's taking a lot of damage.
So much damage.
Uh-oh, pools.
Just keeps himself alive.
Okay. Close calls.
Playing with a dangerous situation there, and I had to correct something I did say earlier. I did say that he faced off Ika and beat him. Ika did not match up against Selfie. He went into the split a little later than that, so Selfie did not face off against an LCS jungler during Challenger this split, but we've seen him up against some of the best Europe has had on his time in HDK, but
true.
He's able to do a decent job against Power of Evil for the most part.
He certainly seems to have grown a lot as a player in Challenger, as Alfari spends his teleport, following Soaz back up towards the top side. And it is always good to keep an eye on him as well, to see what he's going to be getting up to in this whole match, because his Vladimir has been crucial in the last two games. Even though they couldn't really get much done in game number one, Ignar going in on the Hybrid gets the knock-up on it. Him and a few minions. Hansama continuing to have really no trouble this game.
10 CS lead as well. There's a lot of extra CS in the wave for Misfits that's stacking up here and is going to end up under the tower. But still, Peke can't get his hands on that. There's multiple creeps dying here before Peke can actually get them. There's another one about to die by Ignar. So it is lost CS to maybe the Void. I don't know where they go.
Yeah. You get cycled back around. It's a very green rift.
It's just money all over the floor.
Yeah. So, I mean, this is what it comes down to, too, playing for that late game. All eyes are really on Amazing. What can he get done in the lanes? Where is he going to choose? He tried going down bottom, But Llama Bear was already there.
Yeah.
This is why they're picking Gragas first. They know they can get involved a little quicker.
Yeah, and the thing is, Amazing also gave away that blue buff to Parabeagle, as we saw. Parabeagle is now using that to compound his lead in the mid lane. Selfie
or
had
was,
to
rather.
Back away. But look at it, Parabeagle stayed in lane, not forced to use a potion or anything. Because of the extra laning time and just the presence he's had, is pretty much dominating this matchup against Selfie. So the first time in three games that we're seeing that happen.
Uh-oh, you're on a ward, boys.
Ah, they're fine with it. It doesn't. Again, all they're trying to do is kind of push forward in the lane, just show presence here, and make sure Peke is just losing farm time and time again.
Yeah.
This time he gets it with the Bouncing Blade, and gets two of them, or the Boomerang.
This is good for Misfits in the bottom side, but I mean, that difference in the mid is so huge right now. You take a look at the gold between the two of them, and it's like 400 that Selfie's missing out on versus Power Beeble. I mean, that's a rough start for him.
Very rough. Neither running TP, neither of them have done for the entire series.
Yeah, it's all been Ghost Flash. Oh, Peke, good spell shield, but he can't stop the knockup now. Deadly Flourish takes another bite out of him.
But again, Misfits just take the trade initially. Put the damage down and will back themselves away. The CS gap is going to close, but it does mean that Origen will be later on the recall here. Hansama will still remain about 10 CS ahead after this wave has gone if Origen don't stick around for another wave. And if they do stick around for another wave, that then punishes them on the back end of this, because they're going to try and shove it back out into the turret. And unfortunately, that normally would result in them being super far behind, but Hansa stayed as well. It was only even now recalled.
Yeah, that's curious. So Hybrid's going to have to back off now. Dancing Grenade, oh, does not quite get the stop on the Deadly Flourish. Or does, actually. Excuse me. That one was quick to see. Now they both back off.
Ignar's mid lane. Power does have ultimate and both summoners. Junglers are here as well, so Power will already know that Amazing has spotted out Llama Bear, but is he expecting the Alistar? Ignar wants to go. Here comes Hybrid mid, though. And everybody's backing away.
No one wants this.
Everybody realizes what is about to happen here. And nobody wants to fight.
Let's take five and try that again. Very even in the gold game, though. Misfits, right about the same in it. Even despite the gold differential that Power had built up over Selfie. Ignar going a little deep to get some ward in. Get some wards in this jungle. Make sure he can't push too far off. Alfari, meanwhile, up in the top, does take a chain barrel, and so as is starting to fight back. Still, he finds himself down on the CS as well.
Yeah, to be expected in this matchup. Again, another one that is, this time tough for Soaz.
Talk about dancing with the tower damage.
Llama Bear and Amazing have tracked each other this entire game long. Although Amazing doesn't see Llama Bear here.
Yeah, there is the Gangplank ulti. Alfari's a little low, but Meganar is coming soon. And Amazing getting knocked back into Alfari just in time for first blood over to the top laner, a Misfit.
Importantly, Llama Bear hadn't moved, and that meant Amazing didn't get the tracking on him through the Tremor Sense. And from that point, Misfits already had Amazing surrounded, basically surrounds himself, and that ends up falling for it. Ultimate was even held by Alfari, so easy pickup onto Amazing for the first blood.
Soaz will be able to get a wave clear away, but still, gold goes into the pocket of the top laner from Misfits, a little bit extra on top of his CS advantage. Starting off not too bad for Misfits in two out of three lanes. Selfie backed away, lost out on quite a lot of farm there, but you know, he's still hanging on. And Llama Bear, yeah, he has really been everywhere on the map where Amazing has been, just in as much time. Mountain Drake here on the Rift. Origen trying to get some vision around the backside of it.
Llama Bear, sorry. I heard you say Llama Bear. Like,
take two animals, combine them.
Yeah, whichever.
And, yeah.
Although, I guess in
it's called the Avatar strategy.
I suppose it is. Although, I guess in this setting with this skin for Llama Bear, he's actually Llama Bear.
I didn't know where you were going with that. And when I found out, I'll give you a reluctant clap for that. Okay. Back to this bottom lane.
Didn't even clap for...
I did,
a little
bit.
He was at home to hear it.
Yeah.
I guess it was a really reluctant clap on that as well. Just don't want to give me any credit there.
I try.
Look, I know I'm not normally funny, and that wasn't funny either, so I'm trying.
No, that made me smile in spite of myself. That's what it made me do. As Llama Bear, by any name, finds a ward. And Power's going for the chase down on Selfie. That ghost in, a lot of damage here. Selfie's got to be careful. Has to watch his back.
Glad to see Power putting on a decent performance in this lane. Had a lot of good kind of segments to fights in the last game. Getting damage out, ultimates connecting, despite the team being behind. So for Origen, they certainly still have shown glimpses of why a lot of fans don't expect them to lose this series. especially in game one. Game one was such a convincing.
Oh, it was incredibly clean, too. And they just denied everything Misfits wanted to do. But you know, the Misfits of game two came out very differently. And in all honesty, they should have cleaned it up in half the time it took them to finish. But Origen fought back. But then they made a couple of key mistakes as well. And Misfits were able to pick up the win off the back of it. And now the series is kind of hard to call.
Well, this the vibe of this game feels a lot more like game two than game one. Llama Bear's been more active on the map. Origen are a kill down. Now, that's obviously not identical to the last game, but it was Misfits that took the kill lead to begin. And Alvari is now really hammering Soaz in this match.
Okay, Soaz is just going to take the precaution of having some citrus before the wave comes crashing into his tower. Be able to have no trouble clearing that one away.
Yeah.
He does with the chains.
This is a difficult matchup until Soaz gets his minion force. That's the point at which he can clear pretty much all of the minions with the barrel setup. Until he can do that, he has to clear the ranged ones with the barrels and then kind of get whatever melee minions he can from the wave as it pushes under tower. So it's a bit of a precarious match. You don't want to stray too far forward to get minions with auto attacks. So a lot more on Q farming early on.
Yeah. Gold is, CS is actually evened in the bottom lane between Hansama and Peke. It's fairly close. Okay, so climbs up to about 8, and now Peke does back away.
Mm-hmm.
But still.
Just the ebb and flow of being in lane and leaving lane,
yeah.
The way the wave pushes out. It's that Peke gets the wave and kind of closes the gap, and then Hansama gets the wave and extends it again. So back and forth, this will go until Peke gets caught out or Hansama gets caught out, either one.
Yep, taking a look at the gold, he still managed to climb himself up 300 more, working towards his items. Alfari still has a bit of a wave to deal with. Nearly Meganar, he's going to chase Soaz off the slow way. Put some more damage onto this turret, so slowly but surely, Misfits are pushing in. Again, 2 out of 3 lanes.
Yeah, and what Alfari was doing there is, because he was about to be Meganar,
nice fadeaway barrel.
Because he was about to be Meganar, what Alfari was doing is delaying the conversion to force the turret to kill the minions under tower. And what that did was force Soaz back away, because while Alfari is in Meganar, Soaz can step a lot closer to the wave than he normally could do. Nice play, Soaz. Auto attack the barrel to make sure the Q follow-up is there after the first timer goes down. So Alfari doesn't get punished for being in Meganar by Soaz getting free farmed.
Mm-hmm. Ignar's up in the top, by the way. He's gone quite a far ways from home.
Welcome to Ignar on Alistair. He's just like, I'm just going to go top. He's going to go mid. Power of Evil's just going to go half the way to Selfie's health bar.
Yeah, and now the rest of Origen have arrived here to try and push on the tower, but there's no more wave. Selfie's at half health, but they can't really follow through.
Mid lane party?
No.
Vision
was
there.
Yeah, good thing for Llama Bear, it's bring your own barrel.
He's the only one that is bringing anything. I guess GP is. He's got lots of.
That's true, he does.
Basically, GP is hosting the party at this point.
Yeah, we'll see you later in the game how that one goes down. For sure, Ignar getting the knock-up onto Amazing. Headbutts him as well,
although
he's tunneled out.
There is one thing after going around some old naval ships, which is something that, I guess, when you're on holiday in the UK, because there's really nothing to do, there's no sun, no beach.
I wasn't sure where you were getting that one from. Yeah, okay. Do
they actually, they used to keep bodies in, like, the rum barrels to bring them back afterwards. Yeah, you've got a horrible look on your face. I'm sure other people do. This is quite a disgusting fact. Around the HMS Victory and Nelson's ship, like, they used to keep, they brought the body back in, like, a barrel with alcohol in it because it preserved it. So pretty nasty stuff. So I wouldn't trust what GP's bringing to the party. I'm going to be honest.
Yeah, I think that's definitely a lesson to learn. All right. Let me get my mind off of that one for a second as Ignar's still
it's
waiting
history.
Out patiently. It is? Still gross.
Peke might be history in the bottom lane.
Yeah,
Ignar's Q Flash could come out here and it would be a real difficult thing to spell shield. You can see Ignar's get ready to go.
That was a tense moment for Peke.
The thing is, Peke knew in that scenario. He didn't want to stay. Oh, hang on.
Way to get to the barrel. Big ult, and in comes Llama Bear, knocking him back in. And Selfie comes out of nowhere and picks that kill up.
Okay. Soaz, once again, same as the last game. This time, not overextending, but caught out in the side lane.
Are they going to try to save this?
Hang on. Ignar's roaming up to
Alfari
mid lane.
Alfari is coming. It's going to finish, but they can't finish this off unless they can get around the backside. Peke exhausted. In comes Selfie around the side. Power of Evil had already ulted on the back of it, but it wasn't enough to get anyone down. Ignar is just running and gunning on out of there, and now Alfari turns around for Peke. Doesn't have the damage. Peke picks him up. Selfie, though, wants to turn it. Look at these low health bars, but they can't finish the job.
Everybody is so low. Peke throws out the blade.
Oh, amazing. Taking out Llama Bear now. Looking for Ignar. They've actually managed to turn this. Hansama finally gets the kill, but Soaz has arrived. And this has gone real messy. All said and done, it is a 3-for-1, and Selfie is
it?
On
Hang
the
on.
Retreat. Finishes off the barrel. Oh, he's got no pool, though, and nowhere to go. Soaz with the kill.
Put that one in the barrel. Selfie is down for the count, and Origen are going to keep pushing the mid lane. That was just Misfits taking a little bit of an uneven numbers fight in the mid lane, and Origen are going to come out way ahead with that. Now they're going to push for that inner tower as well, take it down, and really reap the benefits of that team fight.
Oh, yeah, they do. And that was when Misfits wanted to start. Let's look at this again. Teleport in the mid, just barely. Alfari's nowhere near Mega. And it looked good for a second.
So Peke dodging out a couple of those hits from the curtain call. Ignat couldn't survive too much longer. Selfie.
Focus was so small
this
fight. Doesn't
have the damage. Yeah, Alfari goes up onto Peke and amazing rather than coming down and helping the rest of the team because he was trying desperately to get into Mega. Now, good knockup from amazing to delay some of Llama Bear and Selfie's damage coming out.
Amazing manages to get a kill off when he's surrounded. I mean, yeah, that was that was all kinds of messy.
Hansama ends up on the wrong side of the fight. Selfie ends up getting pillared to keep himself, ends up getting pillared.
Yeah. Where to go for that one.
Flash pillar, by the way, from Hybrid. Nice little placement, just to make sure you can get it. Amazing, since it's business time. Time to go to work.
Certainly, they are back in business. We're 17 minutes into this game right now. Take a look at it again. Okay, that was a quickie.
So we got
right,
the last
fast
couple
forward.
Seconds. There we go.
We're
back up.
Just to catch you guys up. That's called a speed run. All right.
Yeah. It's actually called our second observer getting back up to regular time after a replay. Anybody
don't ruin the magic.
Hey, look, the magic got spoiled. That's like the magician put the sword in, blood came out the side. This is a gruesome cast from me. I'm gonna
Yeah, seriously, man. You're getting into all sorts of morbid things.
Llama Bear is going mid.
Does try to get it off. Peke, unfortunately, had the spell shield. Fortunately for him, rather. So Misfits are in a bit of a quandary right now. They've lost a lot of objectives, a lot of kills, and been down gold in a very short amount of time. And there has been an untouched Mountain Drake on this map for the entire game. And Origen are about to change that.
Well, we have been in standard lane, so it becomes a little more difficult to actually take out the Drake. But with the top lane matchup so one-sided, Alfari's going to stick up there with no TP, which means that there's no real way of Misfits actually forcing him.
Yeah. On the other hand, Soaz does have his Trinity Forces had for a little bit now. I mean, a lot of the gold they gained in that last fight certainly pushed him over the edge. So he'll have a little bit of an easier time dealing with than he would have before. Nonetheless, this is an interesting turn of events.
I was going to say, Origen just saw Deadly Flourish come from their own jungle.
Oh, great cannon barrage, too. This is going to shred this wave.
Soaz gets this tower already. Misfits are having to back away. I don't even know whether they'll be able to regroup fast to defend this bottom tower.
They could have pushed that tower. They could have ended up trading this. I don't think they're going to be able to defend it here. There's no teleport still on Alfari. There's still a wave. Origen have got the boost again.
Trade away. Yeah, Origen are going to get this, I think. Looking at it, it's only Ignaz going to get close.
Oh, the pillar stops him. They're not going to finish it, but that is oh so close.
Very, very close to taking that down. A couple more autos. If Peke had been there initially, he actually went mid to shove it out to try and force somebody to come over. May have been able to get that one down. But Origen in the lead. Misfits are caught a little bit sleeping on that one. Yeah. Not really anticipating the cannon barrage to come out. Yeah,
this is the macro. This is the difference right now.
They did get back in time, though. They just barely get back in time to save their turret.
Still, that could get knocked down at just about any time right now. So, Origen, do not get what they wanted exactly out of that push. They were still able to take a tower in the bottom, which was near to falling anyways. Misfits still looking for a fight, ever trying to engage. And Ignar just keeps on moving all over that map.
Well, if there's one thing Ignar's been looking to do, or wanting to do this game, it's engage on this.
Whoa! How now, Golden Cow? Peke's gone!
Well, we saw the flash. We saw Peke die. And that's what Ignar's been looking for. Peke. Yeah,
speaking of history.
Caught going over the catwalk. That opened quite a few times this split for him.
Man, that was spicy. Okay, this is going to open up Misfits to try and push on this mid tower. Jinzolt. Doesn't connect everywhere he wanted it to, and they're out of minions. Selfie's got to be careful. He got to watch himself. So that is going to be a pool out of there. And for now, Misfits keep on the slow siege.
Quick thinking by Ignar, by the looks of it, just had the vision. Hops over the wall. Pulverize into the headbutt back into the team, and Peke has no chance of getting out from that scenario. So nice little play out by the Misfits to try and get themselves back in this game.
Let's see it again. Here's how it happened.
Oh, Peke just on. Peke was warding. He was got caught warding. That's unfortunate.
Yeah. Oh.
But realistically, shouldn't be there on his own. Selfie.
He's not gonna get out of there without having to turn this one around. Selfie way too low. Turn to stone. And polished off by Power of Evil.
Tried to dodge out on this one. Didn't quite get the timing on the turn. We've seen a couple of them come from Selfie this time.
That's a hard move, man.
Wasn't the case.
So 4-5 in kills. Still a 3,000 gold advantage for Origen here. And compound that with the fact that they've got themselves the Mountain Drake. Things are looking good for this team. But we've shown that Misfits still have some fight in them. And only 20 minutes into this game, there's still plenty of chances to do it. Origen hanging around this Baron pit. A little early to take it, but they will start it off.
Well, they've got a Cassiopeia that's pretty strong.
And there's no Vladimir.
Alfari's on the bottom lane, has just turned Megana.
Does have TP, but it would be hard. Ignar trying to stop it. Double TP is coming in here. Big knockup onto Amazing and Hybrid. Alfari's coming in. Mega's not going to last forever. I'm not sure if they want this one. Alfari's got to hop the wall. He's going to get a big ulti off, but will that be enough for the disengage? Pops the Gangplank barrel. Meanwhile, in the back, the Jhin is sending out big shots, and Hybrid has to flash the last.
Oh, Soas.
The Baron. Soas is way too low. He stopped up. He's going to have to flash away. That was close.
Ooh, woo. But nice sidestep initially on the explosive cast from Soas, but couldn't really take on the Baron damage as well. Was forced to flash out in the end of all things. Llama Bear doesn't have vision on Soas.
I mean, this should be the tower mid, but there's no minion wave, so they're not going to push it in. Instead, there's a big wave pushing down bottom. Do Misfits go for this instead?
No, they're looking for a dive with Ignar. Look, as soon as Peke and Power of Evil push up, Ignar's no ult, but he does have his combo available. No flash. They were looking for it, but they second-guess themselves. Selfie is the only real damage threat that's there because Hansama had pulled back as well, so Misfits were looking to go for the Hail Mary into the mid lane, but wisely perhaps think twice about it and pull themselves back.
Yeah, couldn't quite find what they were looking for. So they don't get anything else out of it, but they did stop the Baron from Origen. And you mentioned it earlier, that Cassiopeia is starting to become a real threat. 2-0-3, finished Seraph's Embrace. Sitting on that Narod of Ages, but there's certainly some more gold in the back pocket. Sitting on 2,500 as he's about to spend that one. That is quite a lot of damage he's about to acquire.
Yeah, what's he going to pick up here? What's he just going to do?
Insta-void
stuff. Straight up by avoid stuff.
Why not, right?
Well, I mean, it's going to cut through the MR that has come out. There's a fair amount. Ignar's even looking for Locket or Banner, whichever one he goes down. So it's a fairly influential pickup right now for Power of Evil.
Next dragon's about a minute away. So Misfits will going to be gunning for this one.
And it's
still
infernal.
It is infernal. You need that if you want to fight it out. Misfits, their favorite dragon.
Well,
tense moments.
Very, very tense. Origen turned this game around from a rough setup. The beginning of the game again went in favor of Misfits.
Yeah, close though. It was still fairly even.
Yeah,
like gold-wise.
It was fairly even. We did see a couple of early kills go out, but then that fight in the mid lane that Misfits took after already basically punishing Soas in the top lane.
They need to kill Power Evil. Like, that's straight and simple. You want to win a fight right now, they've got to kill him.
Yeah, they have to. So Peke is getting stronger and stronger, as is Soas though. Still down in their matchups. You can see that Alfari has done a good job of staying up ahead of Soas despite the team being down. Hansama, one of the rare occasions we're seeing him not up towards the Lucian when it was available. I wonder whether he just feels like he doesn't have the late game damage like in the last game.
I don't know if you can base too many predictions off of last game. Selfie goes in, but he does not have nearly enough damage. Takes a lot himself. Origen, Power of Evil's ghosted here to get back to his team, but he opts not to take it.
Now heading bottom lane against Alfari. No, actually blue buff it was.
Yeah, everyone's hanging around by the Dragon Pit. No one wants to give this one up. Power takes blue buff. Origen still have the river controlled. Misfits have the high ground, but that doesn't mean that much in League of Legends, at least not in this part of it. Selfie pillared. Oh, okay. Crotobell. He's gotten out of there.
That is going to make him closing the gap in fights that a little bit more difficult, considering we're about to have a team fight. Selfie is no ult, no Protobelt. Obviously, Protobelt better to use in that case than his Flash. Flash longer cooldown, way longer cooldown, so not worthwhile if you've got that proto belt available. But it looks like we're going to have the cooldowns back available before any fights actually kick off. However,
amazing. Oh, he ults right on in, but they caught power, and they take him down. That's what they needed. Shin instantly ulting, Peke blocking one, but amazing, tanking the rest of the shots. Look at how low he's falling. Cannon Barrage stopped the first wave of minions, but the second's already there. It's cleared away by Soaz, but still, the rest of Misfits are pushing on.
Origen has to be careful. Ignar still has flash and ult.
In comes the cow. It's going to be spell shielded, but they still knock Hybrid right into the wall. Turn for him. Ignar trying to stay alive, but have they bit off more than they could chew? Turning to finish this tower. Low health bars. Origen looking to re-engage.
Very low health bars on some of Misfits, but the same can be said for Origen. Misfits get the tower, they get the kill. They're going to back away towards the dragon, and maybe they can pick that up for themselves as well. Would be a nice swing in the balance for any Misfits fans watching this one, because this could be the fight that puts them back on the map for game three in this series.
Yeah, they've got waves to deal with, but they did manage to get that Infernal Drake. 26 minutes now on the game clock. Stakes are getting higher every time. Origen still with the gold lead, but it is not that high.
And this time it looked like a really nice play from Llamabet over the wall. There was no ward to protect Power of Evil here, and as he pushes forward, flash body slam into the explosive cask.
Nobody was ready
for that.
That's
a dead Power of Evil. Really nice play out by Llamabet to know that that was a blind
Oh boy, Origen have pulled the trigger. Teleport in, rushing Baron. It's at 4,000 health. In comes Llamabet. No flash for him. He's way too late, and they turn him to stone anyways. But can they get out now? So as low. Barrel gonna knock him back and forth. And in goes Selfie, looking for the kill. Pools. So as gonna fall, but the rest of Origen make it out.
Origen are gonna get out with four heavy pings onto where Hybrid went, but nobody is there to lock him down. Important play by Origin to keep their momentum in this game. They just lost a fight, and now they've got the Baron buff for themselves. It isn't it for their side laner here for Soaz, as he's now fallen, but the rest of the stack is going to be able to have that Baron buff and look to continue to push Misfits back in. So just as Misfits get themselves back in this game, Origin fire back again.
Whew, Origen, they've managed to find it, and they just didn't hesitate at all. Baron went down before Llamabet could even get there. Ult for good measure. It could have been a lot worse.
Important ult there from Power of Evil, because maybe if they missed that timing by half a second on the smite, Llamabet manages to body slam forward and smite it down. The Baron was already at like 900 health, so a pretty critical ult there. Throwing the small cooldown to get the Baron buff, good decision.
Oh yeah. So, gold still remains the same. Hasn't mattered much this game. Origen on the offensive here, stacked heavy towards the bottom side of the map. Selfie though, starting to come into his own, fairly strong. Hybrid blocking out while the red buff is being picked up on the opposite side. And Misfits are gonna have to try and wait this one out, unless they think they're strong enough to take a fight.
Alfari,
face checks right into it.
Beats the barrels, but Alfari still with a large lead, despite, again, the team being down. He's done a really nice job in the side lane.
He's got TP too.
Yeah, he has.
Soaz does not.
Soaz does have Cannon Barrage.
That's true.
Okay, he's not the same as having a TP.
Almost as good.
But he's just at least present in the side lane without having to TP. Yeah.
Well, there's that low tower. I think this might be the end of it here. Hesitance. They're going to run away, give that one up. Too many minions, too strong. Selfie ends up proto-belting out. Push continues though. Origen, they think they're strong enough to keep it going.
Yeah, I mean, credit where it's due in this game to Power of Evil for Origen and Alfari on Misfits for having such large leads in their respective roles. So, I mean, Misfits at least showing that some aspects are hanging on here. Power having a good game. Mm-hmm. A lot of people complained about Power this split, about his performances, but I think another game like this kind of shows you why he is still the starting mid laner. And currently the only mid laner for Origen, despite Peke being on the roster.
Yeah, Peke's played two roles this year, but definitely made the choice to keep Power in that slot and moving Peke towards the AD carry role. He's done all right. He's done what he's needed to do, in all honesty, this series. He's provided the utility time and again. And Origen, you know, it's still 1-1, but they hold the lead this game, and they hold the tempo, importantly. That Baron, super critical. Not something you always think of doing in the Challenger series when you see the quick moves, the quick reactions. This is where the experience comes into play, and Origen certainly have a wealth of it.
Yeah, they have so much experience in comparison to Misfits. When you look at just the sheer number of games played, if you take only kind of...
Oh, and Ignar wants interrupt to go your history lesson here. This is going to be a little rough.
Ignar wants to come over the wall, has his flash up. Origen backing away already.
Yeah, they do not want to face down the cow. Back off. No more tower push for now. Misfits got to get back to mid, though. They're a little bit lacking on their wave control there.
Yeah, nobody's there to clear it, but also nobody's pushing from Origen. The Baron buff has, I believe, just expired.
Okay, so
with the end of that push top.
Misfits ended up giving up, in total, one tower away from that Baron buff, and that's the one that was almost already fully pushed by Origen anyways earlier in the game. So not the worst that could happen as we hit 30 minutes into this game. They're still increasing their gold lead a bit. Baron power play was just shy of 2,000, all said and done.
Yeah.
But Origen are not done here. They want to push on to Misfits. That's not going to be enough there.
Trouble with the mute button there, Pyra.
Just a bit.
See, I've heard you do that to other people. It's the first time I've heard you do that to yourself.
Feels bad, man.
I nearly did that earlier. I nearly put my mute button down, which I'm sure some people would prefer if I did. But nevertheless,
self-burn.
Origen.
You gonna be okay there, man?
Yeah, I'm fine. Don't worry about me. It's all good. Llama Bear might not be fine, though. There's a lot of people around. He does have Ignat and Selfie there with him. I was going to say something and I've forgotten what it was. Can't have been that important. Oh, that's what it was going to be. About Baron Paraplay. You're saying it's just shy of 2,000. So to put it in perspective for viewers that may be new to seeing the Baron Paraplay graphic, it'll start at 1,500 because that is the gold given by Baron. So Origen extended their lead by a further 200 gold after Baron.
Yeah.
So not exactly the largest Baron power.
Well, but getting the Baron was still critical.
Of course, of course.
Yeah. And they lost only Soaz. Remember, like, that's some gold also back onto Misfits for killing Soaz. So, you know, there's a decent bit of math involved. 25 seconds, though, is the next Mountain Drake. Speaking of other objectives.
Alfari, not going to fall for the same trick again.
Not this time.
Oh, I didn't quite get it. Well, then again, I guess.
But he got what he needed. No, maybe.
I don't think he wanted to. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I think he actually didn't want to connect them.
It is a very satisfying thing to, like, chain all the barrel explosions, though.
Yeah, of course, one of the reasons that he might not want to do that, of course, is GP was changed so that the max amount of barrels you can hold is, like, 3, I think it is now. Or is it active barrels on the map? Changed a long time ago.
Yeah.
Yeah, the recharge is maximum 3.
Still finds himself in the meta fairly frequently. Ignar, man, the big front line. He was trying to get the hit off, but deterred on the wards. Amazing was there. Power of people waiting in the wings. Selfie doesn't know he's on a ward here, but he's still going to back away as he spots power.
All quiet.
Or maybe right back in.
Selfie's trying to turn on the spot.
Yeah, nobody wants to go all in here, but Amazing has started Dragon. Spotted here by Misfits. They will be moving in. Not a full commit, though. Just Peke and Amazing. And Powers join them. Actually, they've got to move quick. Misfits do if they want to get it. Oh, it's still smited at the end. Amazing on the way out. Manages to get that one. Cannon Barrage on the hunt. Hybrid on the chase. Puts the pillar into Ignar. Not enough to close the gap.
Yeah, Hansama did use his heal, though, to get himself faster away. 40 seconds on Baron, and with two Mountain Drakes on Origen, that will get burned down very quickly with Cassiopeia.
Yeah, we have had all kinds of powerful drakes this game. Two mountains on Origen, the one Infernal in Misfits' hands. Can they outfight Origen, though, at the Baron Pit when it comes back up?
Selfie's farmed his way back up now that the lead from Power of Evil isn't as significant. Same can be said for top lane. So as now that his barrels are strong enough to just clear out the wave, he's able to take out every wave in front of him. And Alfari can't punish him for that anymore. We've already reached the point where that is gone. Two upgrades already for Soaz. Just raise morale that's missing.
Okay, Misfits are gonna wrestle some more map control here. Yeah, Soaz has definitely been pretty powerful in this game, and he even goes so far as to upgrade into his Mortal Reminder. Remember, he had gone for not really early this game like we did see a while back, but the Executioner's Calling just to deny some of the healing from Selfie.
And there was a lot of talk initially when GP came out that Armor Pen would be bad on him. In this case, Executioner's Calling and into the Grievous Wounds was super necessary.
Not to mention the Serrated Dirt gives him even more Armor Pen.
Exactly, but the initial discussion was that you just wanted, like, flat or crit when it came to damage rather than Armor Pen, just because of the way his barrels ignored armor, part of the armor anyway. So at this point, engage coming, Hansama.
Okay, he managed to hobble away. They get a couple of knockups, dodging most of the Cannon Barrage. Ignar still taking some punishment here. Ult is active on him, and Selfie looked to chase down Amazing. Will he be able to find it? Not quite.
Alfari just turned Meganar in the bottom lane. Neither TP has been used from the top laners, so we won't quite get to see just how good the Grievous Wounds is going to be. We've seen it two games in a row. So again, yeah. Soaz with the write off.
Okay, opens up the curtain ball, but Amazing is right around the back, and Hansama does get canceled. Can Llama Bear help Hansama turn this one around? Flashing away. Meanwhile, back on the front line, Selfie and Ignar are going to join right back up with the teleport in. Mininar only for Alfari, but he's still hopping away before he does too much damage or takes too much damage. Power going forward, but he doesn't connect with the Petrifying Gaze.
Oh, Selfie wants to continue on Soaz. Yeah, Alfari building Megana.
And he just keeps hitting those autos, hopping, not going to let Hybrid get away too easily. He does have Flash available. Meganar incoming now. Baron's live. Misfits are moving for it.
They're moving for it, but I think it's more of a bait right now to try and catch someone from Origen. But look at the amount of wards they just had to sweep through. Origen aren't going to push through this anytime soon, not drastically anyway.
That's a lot of blue trinkets.
This is a lot of blue trinkets. Amazing comes back into the fight full health.
And Selfie is going to join up with this team. Look at how low Misfits are right now.
But
Origen might want to fight this again.
If Misfits recall and Origen spot it, Origen can just start on the Baron. Because remember, two Mountain Drakes plus a Cassiopeia. If they get the good fight here... Ooh.
This is tense.
Hansama's running back out for this. Ignar's trying to recall in safety. But again, they're drip by drip going back to the base.
Seeing if they can get themselves healthy. Still harassing. Hybrid's fairly low as well. Worth noting, this is still much of a toss-up of a fight. 36 minutes. Ignar gets out. OG turn their fortunes mid. See if they can get anything else here, trying to push a wave. They do clear away what's come crawling out of the base.
And as soon as they see Hans, they know he's ults up the wave clear.
See, they can clear it away. So as Ghostblade, he is tanking every shot of the curtain call. Eats an orange. And he's going to be able to get out for now, but very low in this. Teleport still available for him if he wants to go back to base.
Yeah, if he wants to go back, he can join the fight. Still has his ult up as well.
Look at the side waves, though.
Yeah, side waves. Big wave pushing top, but Power of Evil's going up there, so you don't need to use a GP ult for it. Bot lane is actually pushing away from Origen right now. Fairly large stack down there.
Misfits, are they
going for this?
They are going for this. Hyper's amazing. He's right behind the pit here. They don't have the Mountain Drakes. This one's going to be a little harder to do. Selfie is trying to guard here. Alfari is Meganar, and they get the knockup. They're going to be able to secure it. Smite it down. Llama Bear, this time the execution is what they wanted. Now they've just got to get out of dodge.
Snap decision making from behind. Now
they're
going
to try to fight. Hybrid flashing away. Selfie finds Amazing, and Amazing finds him as well, but he's able to regen through it all. Meanwhile, there's a fight going up top, and Ignar will give his life over to Soaz. It is a one for none. But Misfits get the Baron.
But a change in mentality from the last time Misfits made that kind of play. They're playing from behind, and they get the Baron and back away. They don't have to force any kind of fight there. They don't need to try and trade. So even though they're behind in gold, Misfits have come right back into this one. Origen have done a good job this entire game of picking fights out, and Misfits finally find the opening to go for a Baron. Both teams looking for those small windows of opportunity, and it's finally Misfits that have got it because they rush it down, and Ignar, this time on Alistar, this time has enough presence to deny Amazing's entry into the fight. Gets him out of the back of the pit early and keeps him out of the pit. He pays for it with his life, but that is a very small price to pay for the rest of his team getting a Baron buff.
Oh yeah, threw the exhaust down on Soaz. Maybe he thought he was going to get away. Don't know. Either way, 6-6 in kills right now. 2,000 is the goal difference. It hasn't been much, but look what's about to spawn. The Elder Dragon is coming up, and Origen are going to want to fight over this one.
All of this has been Misfits playing from behind as well. Selfie has managed to keep pace with Power of Evil in the last few teamfights. A couple of ults not quite hitting as well from Power, and it's meant that they just haven't quite had the damage. That one kind of went out without many people dying, and now Misfits looking for this.
They get the vision. They're not going to start this one off. They have already started to change up their playstyle through this series.
Pekka has got
on the hunt.
They find
Hansama! He knows he's a dead man! And Pekka grabs him. Amazing. Ulting on in. And the rest of Misfits are going to back away.
Yeah, they need to back out of this and get somebody to the mid lane to wave clear. It's not likely that it's going to be in time. Origen are going to try and brute force this straight through the front door here. Amazing's going to tank this up.
He's going to tank it up. They don't need the minions. They say they can just go on to Mountain Drake. But in comes Misfits. Shredded, but they just didn't have the damage to finish the job.
Yeah, no bonus on it because the minions weren't there. So just so little damage with them trying to turn onto it. And Origen are going to have to back away from that. They'll look for the Elder Drake. Hansama still down for 25 seconds. Should give Origen this Elder Dragon without too much of a fight. But look at Selfie moving in. He is already trying to get that flank on.
Are they going to fight
Selfie's
this? Selfie comes right on in the middle. Instantly
he's
crossed
alone,
out. But now can he get out? No, he's going to get chunked across. But so is Origen. Amazing. Soez both low, trying to fight over this one as Soez picks up Selfie with a barrel explosion. And that is going to be Ignar trying to distract, pushes Soaz back again. We've seen this one before, but Alfari is going to be left for dead. The rest of the team are starting to melt. It's only Llama Bear and Hansama available. Teleport by Soaz is going to be canceled.
Trying to take out Llama Bear on the end of it, but Origen realized that they don't need to do that to get the win here. Selfie,
curtain call,
going in alone.
Uh-oh.
Has pretty much cost
Llama Bear.
Misfits.
Llama Bear, he can't get back to his own base safe in time. Hansam is going around the long way. This is definitely going to be inhibitor. 40 minutes into the game, these death timers are long.
40 seconds still on Alfari, 25 on Selfie. Origen, despite losing out the Baron buff, have just cracked the first inhibitor of this game. They want to continue to go. Misfits, they still have Llama Bear, they still have Hansama. They should be able to hold this.
Just trying to distract. Big barrel there, but Keke, the rest of the team, they started to turn on Nexus turrets already. Still 4 seconds on Ignar.
Let's go.
8 on Selfie. They're
Ignar
going to take him out.
That's it.
Origen are going to be able to get the game. They're right back in business. 41 minutes. They take a big victory.
Oh, my word. Misfits had come right back into this game. It was all on the Baron buff at that point. They had the Baron to start pushing Origen back. Origen had had the lead for the majority of the game. And the decision by Misfits to just go aggressive one by one into the Elder Drake pit.
Selfie, I mean, you gotta look at it. That face just says it all, man. He was like,
why that decision?
I have no idea.
Just let it go.
Yeah. It's,
you've got the Baron buff. Origen, you just avoid the fight if they end up getting the Elder. At worst, you just let Llama Bear try and steal it.
But, you know, they let their worst tendencies get the better of them that time around. So Misfits, you know, effectively have a game that is very winnable. It's very back and forth, but it's played from behind the entire time. And that one mistake, when the death timers are too long, you can't afford to do it.
Yeah, I think maybe the thinking was we're up against such strong late game that if we don't win a fight now, even with the Baron buff pushing, maybe we won't get it. But,
yeah.
Man, Origen, for the most part, great game.
Oh, yeah. And they've got some time to think it over as they get ready for what could be the final game of the night. But for now, we're going to, for more of the match, we're going to actually head into the analyst desk and take a look one more time.
Wow, yeah, I love the way Stress said it there. Origen, for the most part, great game. So without that chart in the middle. And Origen could actually take this the next game if they keep it up. You wanted to focus a little bit on not so good movements by Origen a little bit earlier in the game.
Yeah, I was actually convinced that they were going to be able to turn this around on the side of Misfits, and a lot of that was due to some of the proactive plays coming out of Llama Bear in the jungle. We saw in the mid game some beautiful Gragas play catching out Power of Evil as he came over the wall. I think we'll get a chance to look at that, and it's really, really just excellent play. You're going to see him walk up over and Trashy. Mm-hmm. I want you to run this down for me.
Yeah. So obviously. This is a really good play by Llama Bear. Like, you know that a Gragas player is confident in his play when he constantly uses his E, his E flash combo aggressively, and that's what he did here. So, for a new guy that hasn't been playing on a professional scene for he's completely new to it all, then I'm happy to see that he's pulling these off. Because when you play Gragas at the highest level, you need to be able to pull this off to have impact in the game. And so it made me happy to see that.
Yeah, it's very interesting because we did have some doubts, you know,
yeah.
In comparison to Wisdom for Llama Bear coming in. But it seems like he is growing throughout the series, I would say. Unfortunately, Misfits wasn't able to hang on to their lead. What do you think happened, Mickey?
I think Origen just played it pretty well. They sneaked the Baron, so I didn't expect that one. That was pretty clutch call from them.
Mm-hmm.
And then expect a flashing in to get the Jhin like at the end so they could get Elder Drake, because it was a 45 fight and Misfits just engaged 45 and lost the game. So yeah, I think Orji played it well and Misfits kind of misplayed it.
Yeah, let's take a look at that, because we I was going to say
we're very critical
we're very critical of
poor
Peke's
positioning. Yes,
but we're nice.
Yeah, you like this, the synergy completing each other's sentences. You can watch here. He goes forward, he gets aggressive, he gets that kill, and this ends up being the decision that is the catalyst.
9 times out of 10 he dies that right away, but
Sivir is smurfing.
He made the right choice this time, and you can see as we push forward to this Elder Dragon fight, what do you think is going through Misfits' heads here? Peke's taken one member out, and they opt for the 4v5.
I'm not too sure, actually. I think giving Elder Drake is fine here. Like, they can obviously just wave clear and wait out these 2 minutes where they will have this Elder Drake. So I think it's it shows that they don't have the experience of just they're a man down, give the objective and stall and wait for you to be five again and then fight, right? So I think this series really shows that the experience OG have in the mid and late game, that they, for example, sneak the Baron, right? They I feel like they have an itch in that area. And if Misfits don't get like huge leads in the early game or early mid game, then I think OG in general are just smarter about the game. And I think that has shown in all three games.
Yeah, I think it's super interesting because most people had predicted a whitewash for Misfits coming into this one.
Hey.
You didn't.
All right.
Yeah, all right. Actually.
We can't all be right.
Right, Trashy. So if OG takes the next game, that means that Trashy is our local crumbs and can rise up.
Probably Trashy.
Yeah. Yeah, probably Trashy. You guys also said during the game that it's very, very hard to predict what's going to happen next because even though OG seems to have those clutch calls, next game it could turn all the way around and Misfits could run over them early.
Yeah.
So
I was really confused by Misfits changing up the draft for this game. Like they opted for the Jhin Alistar lane, whereas before they went for the Karma Lucian. I think both were open, if I recall correctly. So I was kind of surprised that they wanted to change it up because they were doing well with those two champs. So I'm not too sure, but I think we will see a different Misfit in the next game. They will maybe try something. I could see Selfie maybe playing Kassadin. I know he played this in the past, also in Challenger, and I would like to see him on this champ.
Mickey, if you were Misfits and we know that there's so much quality in that bottom lane, would you like to see them draft just something super ham, all in, dominate lane or lane swap in game?
Maybe a Sion Jhin. Nah. Nah, I think what they draft for bot lane is fine, but I don't know. They go even in lane, but then OG just win because they're better as a team. Mm-hmm. They have better calls. So yeah, that's why they win.
We'll see if Misfits can pull it together. Also going to check in on what's happening over on EULCS2. Rocket is currently 2-1 up over Schalke. That does mean that Schalke took that game 3 and is not out of this one yet. And we're currently into game 3 here with things are pretty equal for a change.
So the thing that I want to point out to you guys right as we jump into this is it looks like we praised Schalke for drafting team fighting last time's round, but this time they've gone with a Kassadin. Oh, well, may have a kill here.
Play by play!
Betsy running for his life. He has the ghost. He's going to make it to safety because Kassadin doesn't have enough damage to be sustained.
Oh, he goes back in.
He wants more. Memento. Oh, box. That's not what you want. Prang does him dirty. One shot over the wall.
Vladimir is balanced champion.
Yeah. Healthy, healthy design. But looking back at the team comp, guys, I'm curious what your thoughts are on the Kassadin Trundle. These are normally champions we see for split pushing. Do you think Schalke can use these for team fighting?
Well, if they get the hit, then it's good because then they can just sit in mid with Sivir and Graves and clear the waves. So. In that regard, it should be fine, and it all depends on if they can snowball. And as it looks right now, it doesn't look like. I think Kassadin is like even at this point, which is fine. If he goes in side lane against the Vladimir, he can win. But this is not the style that I would kind of say that is the best for Schalke right now, because it doesn't look like they actually play the map correctly and respect people in mid. So I'm not too sure. We will see. It hasn't worked for them in the past that much, playing the split push game, because they constantly just look for fights in mid and just brute force fights. So they will have to play smart and wait for Kassadin to scale up, and then they can win the game.
We will see what happens. You can keep track of that over on EULCS2. But here on EULCS1, we have a series on our hands. It definitely looks like it will be going to 5 games, but we'll see if OG manages to close it out in the next one. We'll be right back for more of the 2017 Spring Promotion Tournament.
And I just like, I'm the DJ from Weekend. I'm like, you know, the funniest thing about it is just like how people dance when in the middle of the night, you know? They don't even make sense anymore. You're just like, put your hands up in the air and they're like, yeah.
go for Jin.
I'm coming soon. Jin.
Go for flat, go for. Can you slow?
Yeah.
If you slow,
I chase.
Amazing, SOAS, both low, trying to fight over this one as SOAS picks up Selfie with a barrel explosion. And that is going to be Ignar trying to distract, pushes SOAS back again. We've seen this one before, but Alfari is going to be left for dead. They're right back in business. 41 minutes, they take a big victory.